some good church because of things that happen in the church. All you know is more good stuff that happened in church than bad. And I'm with the church right now. I thank God for the church. Because it was in church where I got saved and accepted. Hallelujah. I'm gonna preach for the next few fleeting moments. Repeat after me. You're gonna need power for this work. Say it again. You're gonna need power for this work. You know, it's tragic to be around wise people and still making foolish decisions. It's tragic to be around the answer, but still walking around looking like the question. What I'm saying to you is this, is that you ought to want to get full benefit of your relationship with Jesus Christ. Sometimes people are talking so loud you can't hear God. What you got to do is you got to turn God up and turn people down. I learned how to hear what people say, but I can still hear my God. I don't care what you say. And I got a radar for people who say things that are contrary to God's word. You got to have a radar on the inside of you. You want to love God's word so much that you got a radar. Anything opposing to God's will and his purpose. Beep, 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 beep. No, I don't care how good it sounds. I don't care how you tell me God, go bless me. I don't want to shout for a lie. Hallelujah. I'd rather cry about the truth than to shout about a lie. You got to learn how to be satisfied just having the Holy Ghost. You may not be fashionable, and you may not be in with whatever of the latest design or passion is, but I want you to understand something. What makes me in style is I got the Holy Ghost. I want you to understand something. You out of style if you don't have the Holy Ghost. In many churches, we don't talk about the Holy Ghost. We call it the Holy Spirit. And I tried to tell y'all on last week that there's a difference between your spirit and the Holy Spirit. Most of us, we're operating off of our spirit, but not the Holy Ghost. And I want you to understand something, that Jesus is trying to get these disciples ready, because he speaks to them in the book of Luke chapter 10, and he tells them the harvest is truly ripe, and the laborers are few. Now, I thank God for your days, but who's saved on the count of you? Yeah. When you got the Holy Ghost, it's just like walking around with Jesus in your hip pocket. Hallelujah. When you got the Holy Ghost, it's just like you walking around with Jesus in your purse. When you got the Holy Ghost, it's like walking around with Jesus in your life. And that's what Jesus was trying to tell the disciples. He said, I'm going to my daddy, but I'm going to send you another spirit. And this spirit that my father's going to send you is just like having me. He said, I don't want to leave you, but I got to go. Because I'm going to prepare a place for you. He said, but while I'm gone, I got a work for you to do. But I want you to know you're not going to be able to complete this work without the Holy Ghost. But you got to learn that when things happen in the spirit, that you cannot respond with a carnal reaction. The Bible said that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against the principalities. You don't have an enemy that you can see, but the enemy that you have, you can't see it with your natural eyes. That's why you got to have the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will help you to stay when you want to leave. The Holy Ghost will help you to hang in there when you really want to give up. The Holy Ghost will help you to press your way when you really want to turn around.
Yes! wants to work in your life. So you ain't got to say yes to me. But when you say yes to God, see, the Holy Ghost will work with you. The Holy Ghost will work for you. And you can't protect yourself, but when the Holy Ghost comes, it'll cover you, it'll keep you, it'll lead you, it'll guide you, it'll lift you, it'll strengthen you, it'll speed to you. Thank God! And the Holy Ghost said, you just let me drive. You won't run into so many potholes. You just let me drive. You won't make so many mistakes. And you just let me drive. Tell your neighbor, if you want the Holy Ghost to drive, so you got to move out of the seat of authority, get from behind the steering wheel, and let go. And let go. Have his way. Have you ever seen two people driving one car at the same time? Oh, take your hands up. Get out of the way. Let go. Have his way. Let go. Let the Holy Ghost in your marriage. Let the Holy Ghost in your relationship. Let the Holy Ghost in your career. Let the Holy Ghost in your finances. Let the Holy Ghost in your heart. And when you let the Holy Ghost rule, victory is yours. To figure it out, because God has already worked it out. Stop trying to figure it out, because the answer has already been given. There is no temptation common to man that God has already prepared a way of escape.
So if I got the same spirit that Jesus had,
hey!
And I ain't got to play for no reason. Cause it's in the spirit that's in me. So even when my flesh gets sick, I shift from flesh to spirit. And the spirit makes my flesh line up with the spirit. But the spirit can't take control when the flesh is still in the driver's seat. Look at your neighbor, tell a neighbor, take the seatbelt off. Slide over. Get out of control. Let the Holy Ghost get his rightful place. And the Holy Ghost will lead you. The Holy Ghost will lift you. The Holy Ghost will guide you. The Holy Ghost. You want the Holy Ghost to stay with you. You got to make room. Tell your neighbor, make some room. You got to remember, hallelujah, what Isaiah says in the 63rd chapter. Even when life doesn't look like it's going to bring you to the thing that God promised. Can I tell you that your life don't have to look like what God